Hello friends, welcome to eKida. Title of the lecture is Step and Touch Potential. So to understand what is step and touch potential, we first need to understand how energy dissipates across conductive objects. See, during broken pole or down wire condition, some really good conductors exist that provide path. Some really good conductors exist that provide path to ground, including metal fences, wet soil, and puddles. And other conductors also exist that may not be so good. So not so good conductors also exist. Yet still allow current to travel to ground, such as trees, wood fences, and utility poles. See, you all know this, that wood is typically thought of as an insulator, but wet wood will conduct electric current. So when an energized conductor falls across a chain link fence or directly to ground, the object and immediate area become energized, creating a zone of high voltage in relation to the ground. Creating a zone of high voltage in relation to the ground. So the actual voltage depends on source, resistance of the object, soil condition, which include material and moisture. So the dissipation of voltage from a grounded conductor or from the grounded end of an energized object. So the dissipation of voltage from a grounded conductor is known as ground potential gradient, and voltage drops associated with dissipation of voltage, this dissipation of voltage drops associated with this dissipation of voltage is known as ground potential. So the voltage decreases rapidly with the increasing distance from the ground end. See, there is also another way of describing this. Take an example, a stone dropped in a pond. So stone creates ripples that actually fade as they move from the center. So voltage is highest at the source and fades as energy moves across the ground. So first is the step potential. So when a fault occurs, the fault current flows to the ground, due to which potential gradient near the electrical equipment develops, and this potential gradient may affect the person in two ways. First, step to step contact, and second, touch contact. When current is flowing from an overhead conductor through a link fence to the earth, a high voltage condition is created and a voltage gradient will occur based on the resistivity of the soil, resulting in a voltage difference, which is also known as potential difference, between two points on the ground. So this is called a step potential, as it can cause voltage difference between a person's feet. See, difference in voltage creates current flow through the person working in a voltage gradient. This is the diagram. Now, second one is the touch potential. So, touch potential is the voltage between any two points on a person's body. Elbow to hip, hand to foot, and so on. Now, touch potential. Touch potential is the voltage between any two points on a person's body. Example, hand to hand, shoulder to back, elbow to hip, hand to foot, and so on. For example, if an overhead conductor falls on a car and a person touches that car, so current could pass from the energized car through the person to ground. So this is known as touch potential. So how to protect yourself? During storm condition, the first thing to remember is that power lines may not be in a proper configuration. So for your protection, keep in mind these basic storm safety rules. That do not assume that all the coated, weatherproof or insulated wire is just telephone, television or fiber optic cable. Also, do not assume that a downed conductor is safe simply because it is on the ground or it is not sparking. One more thing, never go near a downed or fallen electric power line. Assume that it is energized, touching it could be fatal. So these are some basic safety rules. Just keep in mind, and these are the step and touch potential. Thank you.